of the Lord. There is a word from the Lord this morning. We thank God for all of our visitors that have came out to worship with us this morning. Job chapter 1. And we will go to verse 7, then verse 8. Job chapter 1. There was a man in the land of Oz whose name was Job. Help me read, church. And that man was perfect and upright, underlying perfect and upright, and one that feared God and eschewed evil. Let's go to verse 7 and verse 8. And the Lord said unto Satan, when comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down. Verse 8. And the Lord said unto Satan,
have thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect man and upright man, one that feared God and eschewed evil?
Let's go to Job 14 and 1. Job testifies this. He said, a man that is what? Born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. You can take your seats. Title for this message this morning, I'm struggling, but I am living right. I'm struggling, but I'm living right. There's a struggle that takes place when we're talking about the sanctification of this new life. Of being saved is a work in progress.
Yeah,
I'm struggling, but I'm living right. There is something that goes on in the struggle.
Yeah,
there is a fight within the flesh and the spirit, man. And we'll deal with the fight that goes on with us. I'm struggling, but I'm living right. There's things that we struggle with. We struggle with relationships, but I'm living right.
Yeah.
Some relationships don't cause you not to live right.
Yeah.
But I'm struggling with relationships, how to get along with people. I'm struggling in my finances, but I'm living right.
Yeah.
Somebody don't get it yet. I'm struggling with maybe low self-esteem, but I'm still living right. I'm suffering, I don't get along with my parents, but I'm still living right. I'm struggling in ministry with some of these church folks, but I'm living right. Catch it. I'm struggling on this job with this boss and these employees, but I'm living right. Because sometimes you want to go off to make you not live right. And so I'm struggling, but I'm living right. That's the key. It's a shame to be in a struggle, but you don't live right. At least I'm struggling, but I'm still upright before God. Job, we talked about, we read, Job was an upright man. He eschewed evil. There was none like him. He was perfect. But Job, they had a conversation, God, and say, have you considered my servant Job? For he is an upright man. There's none like him. And so you got to put that name. Have you considered Brother Russell? Because there's none like him. He's living right. He may be in a struggle, but he's living right. So don't allow your struggle to determine your salvation. We think because I'm going through, I'm not saved. They that live godly shall suffer persecution.
Yeah.
I'm struggling, but I am living right. Struggling dealing with these children, but I'm still living right. I'm struggling with my identity, but I'm living right. See, there is a struggle there. And I'm going to talk about this struggle. What to do in the struggle. There are some things I want to talk about if I could, dealing with the struggle. Can I go there for a minute? Give God a hand, praise. Come on, you can do better than that. See, the struggle will cause something to take place in your life. Yes, it will. It will cause you to learn how to tear down a stronghold. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Because I'm struggling, but I'm living right, but there's a stronghold that would try to connect itself to you. Let's turn there. Is this word helping anyone so far?
Amen.
Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Listen to this. For though we walk in the flesh, y'all see that?
Yes, sir.
Right. But we do not war after the flesh. We do not compromise with the flesh. We don't negotiate with the flesh. We don't consider the things of the flesh. We don't walk in the flesh. We don't entertain the things of the flesh. Follow along with me. Though we live in this body of ours, this Christian body, we don't entertain the things that will try to connect itself to this flesh. Because I'm struggling, but I'm living right, but there's a force, follow along, that's going to cause you not to live right, and you still have a struggle. See, with the struggle, there's a present help in the time of trouble. There's a present help in a time of the struggle. And so when you disconnect yourself from God, who's going to help you in the struggle? He says, for though we walk in this flesh, this is Paul talking about a spiritual authority. He addressed this to the church of Corinth. Because they didn't understand how to walk this walk out. They didn't understand how to deal with this Christianity without struggle. Can you deal with living for Christ with a struggle? Or everything got to be just right for you? Listen, he says, for though we walk in this flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not what? But mighty through God to the pulling down. Someone said you got to pull down that stronghold. What mama and daddy said about you. What they talked about you in school, pull it down. What your ex-wife said about you, your ex-girlfriend, your ex-boyfriend, pull down that stronghold, because it will cause you to stay in the struggle, but you won't live right. Because you become what you think, for as a man thinking in his heart, so is he. You become what you think, you become what you entertain, you become what you think about yourself. Who do men say that I am? Jesus had that conversation with the disciples. Who did men say that I am? Some say thou art Elijah. Some say you the comforter, son. Some say you a miracle worker. And Peter had a divine revelation and said, thou art the Son of God. Which in heaven, you need fresh revelation to live right. Yes, you do. Because you don't know who you are in your new nature of Christ. This new nature, I'm dealing with something. Let me deal with strongholds. Strongholds is a mindset that accepts a situation as unchangeable. You accept it's a mindset. You position your mind that I can't do better.
Right.
Because my mom or daddy didn't do better. I can't do better. It's a mindset that accepts a situation unchangeable. But the Bible said all things are possible to them that believe. If you have a faith of the size of a mustard seed, you can speak to that stronghold and tell that stronghold, be not removed and be not cast into the sea. I'm still living right.
Still living right.
Don't let people put deal with this, because sometimes we could be in the church, but the church is not in us, because it's a mind condition, because you may be in the struggle, but you got to know you got to deal with the stronghold. It's even though that it's a situation that is contrary to the will of God. Strongholds are like fortresses. Once they are built, they are difficult to attack and take out. It's a tree now. It's fortress now in your mind, because you begin to entertain it. Now you was young, you develop a stronghold. Now you're older, now it's a fortress because you never dealt with it. Some strongholds are drug addiction. That's a satanic force. Strongholds, no matter how the person tries, they cannot let it go. That's a stronghold. When you can't let it go, something that is killing you, something that is destroying your mindset, something that is destroying your liver, but I got to keep helping, so I can't let it go. That's a stronghold, something that you won't let go. So you got to let it go, because it's stopping you, it's hindering you, and you want to stay in that mess, and God will never use you as a message. Because you still stuck. He says, listen to my notes here. He said, it's a, thank you, Holy Spirit. It's an imprison of the mind. Okay. You held captive by your own thoughts. And you have the key to unlock, but you still locked in. By your own self-will, your own motives, and your own desires. Can I get an amen on that? Some strongholds are sexual addictions, such as pornography. Talk back to me, church. You know you ain't watching something that should be nice for you, but you entertaining something else. That's why you on your laptop all the time. You talking about checking my email. You checking out somebody's booty. Yeah, talk back. Such as pornography. It's illicit thoughts captured in the mind, and people are unable to be free. It's illicit thoughts that you entertain. Some strongholds are your attitude, could be a stronghold, like anger and bitterness and frustration and unforgiveness are strongholds. I want to deal with this because I'm struggling, but I'm trying to live right. See, I'm struggling, but I'm trying to live right. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Now let me deal with the struggle. The struggle is make forcible or violent efforts to get free, or restraint or constriction. It confines you.
Right.
Yes, it does. And so you got to be careful that you got to understand that I'm coming through something. Say, I'm coming through something. When Jesus, I'm paraphrasing this story, you read it at your leisure, because I got several scriptures I need to give you. Matthew chapter 26, verse 36 through 46, I paraphrase this story. Listen to this. In the Garden of Gethsemane, many of us know the situation. There was a fight between the wheels. The flesh warring against the spirit, and the spirit warring against the flesh. And so there was a struggle. But Jesus had to get free, or we wouldn't be free today. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but God, your will be done. But before that took place, Jesus said, God, I wish that this bitter cup would pass from me. But you got to have an attitude and say, nevertheless, not my will, but your will to be done. Say, God's will needs to be done in my life. Give God a hand praise. Give God a hand praise. Say, his will need to be done. Amen, amen. Come on, give God another hand praise. Yeah. Now let's go to Genesis 39. Let me deal with this. Can I take my time and teach this? Amen. Genesis 39. Listen to this. Because I'm trying to live right, but there's things that will try to hinder you from living right. There's temptation that calls you not to try to